Hey friends, welcome to the YouTube channel All About Electronics. So in this video, we will implement the different logic gates using the NAND gate. Now in the previous videos, we have seen that these AND, OR and the NOT gate are the three basic gates, while these NAND and the NOR gate are the universal gates. Because using any of these two gates alone, it is possible to implement any logic function. And using either NAND or the NOR gates alone, we can implement any logic gates. So that is why these NAND and the NOR gate are known as the universal gates. So now let us see how to implement the different logic gates using the NAND gate. And first, let us start with the NOT gate. So first, let us see how this NAND gate can be used as an inverter. So we know that if A and B are the input to this NAND gate, then its output is equal to A dot B whole bar. Now if both inputs are same, then its output will be equal to A dot A whole bar, which is equal to A bar, because this A dot A is equal to A. That means if both inputs of the NAND gate are same, then its output is the complement of the input. That means by connecting all the inputs of the NAND gate to the one input, it can be used as an inverter. So that is how these NOT gate can be implemented using the NAND gate. Similarly, let us see how to implement the AND gate using the NAND gate. So we know that if A and B are the input to the AND gate, then its output is equal to A dot B. While for the same inputs, the output of a NAND gate is equal to A dot B whole bar. So if we just complement this output, then we will get A dot B. That means by passing the output of the NAND gate through a NOT gate, it can be used as a AND gate. So we have seen that how to implement the NOT gate using the NAND gate. So let us replace this NOT gate with the equivalent NAND implementation. And if we do so, then this is the equivalent AND gate. So that is how the AND gate can be implemented using the NAND gates. Similarly, let us see how to implement the OR gate using the NAND gate. So we know that if A and B are the input to this OR gate, then its output is equal to A plus B. On the other end, the output of the NAND gate is equal to A dot B whole bar. Now using the De Morgan's law, equivalently, it can be written as A bar plus B bar, right? So basically, just break this bar and give it to the individual variable, and at the same time, also change this sign. That means this A dot B whole bar is equivalent to the A bar plus B bar. Now instead of this A and B, if we apply the A bar and B bar as an input to this NAND gate, then its output will be equal to A plus B, right? Because in this case, we will get this A double bar plus B double bar, which is equivalent to the A plus B. So now, this A bar and B bar signal can be generated by passing this input A and B through the NOT gate. So now, let us replace this NOT gate with the equivalent NAND gate implementation. So this is the equivalent NAND gate implementation of the OR gate. Similarly, let us see how to implement the NOR gate using the NAND gate. So we know that if A and B are the input to this NOR gate, then its output is equal to A plus B whole bar. That is the complement of the OR gate. So we already know that how to implement the OR gate using the NAND gates, right? So to use it as a NOR gate, we just need to add the NOT gate after this circuit. And we already know that how to use the NAND gate as an inverter. So that is the equivalent NAND gate implementation of the NOR gate. Similarly, let us see how to implement the XOR gate using this NAND gates. So we know that if A and B are the input to this XOR gate, then its output is equal to A bar B plus A B bar. And in the earlier video of the XOR and the XNOR gate, we have already seen that how to implement this XOR gate using the AND, OR and the NOR gates. Now suppose, if we want to implement this XOR gate just using the NAND gates, then what is the easiest way? Well, the easiest way is just replace all the basic gates with the equivalent NAND implementation. Because we already know the NAND implementation of this AND, OR and the NOT gate. So as you can see, all the gates have been replaced with their equivalent NAND implementation. So here, these gates in the blue color is equivalent to the NOT gate, while these NAND gates in the green color is equivalent to the AND gate. And this logic circuit in the pink color is equivalent to the OR gate. That means by replacing all the logic gates with their equivalent NAND implementation, we will get the equivalent NAND implementation of this XOR gate. So as you can see, in this implementation, we require total 9 NAND gates. But if you closely observe, then some of these gates are redundant, and therefore, they can be removed from the circuit. Because even if we remove these gates, then also the function of the circuit will remain the same. For example, let's say the output of this gate is equal to X. Now the gate after that is the inverter. That means its output will be equal to X bar. And the next gate is also inverter, which will further invert this X bar. That means the output of this gate is the complement of the X bar, that is equal to X. So instead of connecting this output, we can directly apply this output X to the last NAND gate. That means these two gates are the redundant gates. Similarly over here, let's say this output is equal to Y. So the next gate will act as an inverter. That means its output will be equal to Y bar. And once again, the next gate after that is also inverter. That means once again, it will invert this Y bar. That means its output will be equal to Y. So as you can see, instead of applying this output to the last NAND gate, we can directly connect this output Y to the NAND gate. That means once again, these two gates are the redundant gates. So if we remove all these four gates from the circuit, then also the circuit will remain the same. So this circuit is also equivalent to the XOR gate. And let us also verify that. So if you see over here, then these two gates are the inverter. So their output will be equal to A bar and B bar. Let's say these two gates are gate number 1 and 2. Now the input to this third NAND gate is equal to A bar and B. So its output will be equal to A bar dot B whole bar. Similarly, the input to this fourth NAND gate is equal to A and B bar. So its output will be equal to A dot B bar whole bar. And these two outputs are given to this last NAND gate. Let's say this A bar dot B whole bar is equal to X, while this A dot B bar whole bar is equal to Y. So when this X and Y are given to this last NAND gate, then its output is equal to X dot Y whole bar. Or equivalently, its output is the complement of this A bar dot B whole bar dot A dot B bar whole bar. So using the De Morgan's law, we can say that it is equal to A bar dot B plus A dot B bar, which is the output of the XOR gate. So this circuit is the equivalent NAND implementation of the XOR gate. But as you can see, it requires the 5 NAND gate. Now there is another implementation which requires only 4 NAND gate. So let us see that. So this circuit is also equivalent to the XOR gate. So here, the output of this first NAND gate is equal to A dot B whole bar. Now this output is also one of the input to the next two gates. Let's say these two gates are gate number 2 and 3. So now, if you see the input to the second NAND gate, then they are this A and A dot B whole bar. That means its output is equal to the complement of this A dot B whole bar. Let's say that is equal to X. So using the De Morgan's law, we can say that that is equivalent to this A bar plus AB. Now as per the distributive law, we know that this A plus BC can be written as A plus B dot A plus C. So similarly over here, this A bar plus AB can be written as A plus A bar and A bar plus B. So we know that this A plus A bar is equal to 1. That means it is equivalent to the A bar plus B. That means this A bar plus AB is equivalent to the A bar plus B. Or we can say that this X is equal to A bar plus B. Similarly, the input to the second NAND gate is equal to Bn A dot B whole bar. That means its output is the complement of B dot A dot B whole bar. Let's say that is equal to Y. And using the De Morgan's law, we can write it as B bar plus AB. So once again, using the distributive law, we can write this B bar plus AB as this B bar plus B dot B bar plus A, which is equivalent to the B bar plus A. That means this Y is equal to this B bar plus A. So now these X and Y are the input to this final NAND gate, and its output is equal to X dot Y whole bar. So as we have seen, this X is equal to A bar plus B, while this Y is equal to B bar plus A. That means this X dot Y whole bar, or X Y plus Y bar, is equal to the complement of this A bar plus B plus complement of this B bar plus A, which is equivalent to the A dot B bar plus B dot A bar. That means this overall output is equal to A dot B bar plus B dot A bar, which is equivalent to the output of the XOR gate. So in this way, using the four NAND gates also, we can implement the XOR gate. Similarly, now let us see how to implement the XNOR gate using the NAND gate. Now this XNOR gate is the XOR gate followed by the NOT gate, right? And we have already seen that how to implement the XOR gate using the NAND gates. So if we just connect the NOT gate at this output, then we will get the equivalent XNOR gate. So in this way, we can implement the XNOR gate using the NAND gate. And as you can see, it requires minimum 5 NAND gates. Now there is another way we can also implement this XNOR gate using the NAND gates, and that design also requires the 5 NAND gate. So let us see that. So we know that the output of the XNOR gate is equal to AB plus A bar dot B bar, or we can also write it as AB plus A bar dot B bar double bar. So now using the De Morgan's law, I can write it as complement of this A dot B whole bar dot A bar dot B bar whole bar. So let us try to implement it using the NAND gates. So this A dot B whole bar is equivalent to the applying the inputs A and B to the NAND gate. That means this output is equal to A dot B whole bar. Now these A bar and B bar signals are generated using these two NAND gates. That means here the output of these two gates is equal to A bar and B bar. And when it is passed through the one more NAND gate, then its output is equal to A bar dot B bar whole bar. So let's say this output is equal to X, while this output is equal to Y. So the final output is equal to X dot Y whole bar, which is equivalent to the complement of this A dot B whole bar dot A bar dot B bar whole bar, which is equivalent to the AB plus A bar dot B bar. So this is another way of implementing the XNOR gate using the NAND gates. So in this way, we have seen that how to implement the different logic gates using the NAND gate. So similarly, in the next video, we will also see that how to implement these different logic gates using the NOR gate. So if you have any question or suggestion, then do let me know here in the comment section below. If you like this video, hit the like button and subscribe to the channel for more such videos.